Hello, so this was Epic exclusive for a year, and now it's on Steam. It's still early access, but at least it has mod support, and I think you can link your Paradox account to Epic and play it from Epic onto Steam with the same save, I don't know. The game has evolved a lot, but it's still one of the more complete ones. So we have three similar games, Surviving the Aftermath, which is this one, and Zone, and of course The Last Haven. The Last Haven I like because of the combat, well, it's zombies, I think, or whatever those creatures are. And it has more combat and a more linear fashion of, I don't know, development. So you will never have problems understanding why you failed and how to do certain things. Now, Endzone is similar to this one, but it's more based on the RTS genre. So that means sometimes if your supply line or your supply chain fails somewhere, you'll die and that's a little brutal, because if you don't plan something ahead or if something goes wrong, you'll just lose the game. And it's a downward spiral, so I guess this is why I prefer Surviving the Aftermath, even though this game has worse reviews than the other two. In fact, it's actually, well, I guess people are upset about the Epic exclusivity. In fact, this is one of the more fun ones, just because you have two layers, the specialist layer, which is the RPG elements and direct commands, and the RTS layer. So let's just start a new game, no more tutorials. Actually, play on a harder difficulty, it's a barren climate. Without the fertile soil, we'll have a lot of problems. Because fertile soil is used for water and food, of course. Never ended. Frequent catastrophe, contamination level 60%. Why not? Let's play on catastrophes. To be honest, I like on medium one, because if you don't have enough in the beginning, the game can end before it even begins. Well, I like the colony builder part more than the other ones, even though the other ones are very important as well. I want it to be a little unfair, but fair at the same time. And to be honest, I just want a lot of fighters, because the scavengers and other stuff... Okay, let's put it another way. You'll get other specialists, and the other specialists will just do the same jobs as these guys, except that they'll do it either slower or faster, so... 200 SPs per day is not a lot, but if you just make a scientist, it's 300. But they do much, a little less damage. And scavenging is the worst for some of them, like her. So I think it's a little better just to take the scavengers, because they are well rounded. And I guess I'll take some fighters with me, but they have to have at least some decent research ability. Action points, well, they're important, but not so important, so I don't really like how the scouts are made, so... I believe this is mostly placeholder, otherwise it will be better than this. Well, he's a real fighter, we'll take him. The game has a few basic principles that I like. And those are, a lot of the colony can be automized, but some parts of it, like the specialist, will not be able. Yeah, this is Warhammer 40k, the Tau race, for the common good. Yeah, let's start, 92%, well, it's not 100%, but believe me, if you do anything like that, you'll have a very, very bad experience. I played a little bit, about 1 hour, so to see how the game is and what should I do in the beginning, and that's about it. You should also keep in mind that this is a hybrid game, meaning it has an overall map with RPG elements and also RTS elements, so sometimes you need to manage both of them. Especially the specialist part in the beginning is rather taxing on your attention span. And you'll see what I mean by that in a minute. The hardest part for me is keeping all my colonists alive and happy, and also getting a good map. The overall map is not so... it's actually pretty good, because... we have mountains on two sides, it's actually pretty bad. It depends on what resources we have around us. But the research is pretty close. And the big problem I have with the games is sometimes you are just so far away from a good water source. Okay, but apparently not this time. Okay, so you'll mainly be scouting for me. And the campsite is actually your most basic building. I don't have a lot of fertile soil. Oh, actually, I do have a lot of fertile soil. Well, not a bad start, I guess. Wait a minute. Can I build a road in the beginning? No, I have to invite colonists to build that. Eh. So we need a stockpile and also food storage. And now we can just let them gather stuff. So you have to explore the area before you can build there, which is one of the mechanics I don't really enjoy. Oh, we found the ruined house. That's good. Metal scraps over there, a lot of cool items. So here you can put the planks and concrete, and here you can put the food. And the boring part is that you have to use your specialist to build in the beginning, and you have to do it, otherwise no people will come. Let's put that on high and he'll build, even though this is just basically wood on the floor. Okay, I guess that's enough. The rest of the time will be dedicated to getting more resources. Okay, we can get that concrete ruin from over there. And overall, map is only accessible after you build the gate, so we have to play a little bit just doing this. Let's speed up. And usually by day 5 we have a full colony running. I really wanted to play some RTS real-time strategy. Well, this is paused RTS, but doesn't really matter. As not a lot of games are out right now, and most of them are early access. And in early access you play a little bit, you make an update video, and then you wait for a few months. And sadly, after they finish the task, they don't do anything. So you have to do a lot of the things yourself. And yeah, I have to wait for the colonist event. And also, I really need a button that is like this one over here. See resources. Otherwise, it's very hard for you to see where the resources are. Okay, so let's send them a signal. Okay, now we have the peasants, I mean the colonists. You can't control them directly, and they all have their needs, so health, contamination, food, hygiene probably, happiness and so on, workplace and age, yeah. Okay, let's quickly build them some shelters, because it will be a very slow grind from now on. Now, you need to plant, so this will probably be where I chop some wood, this will probably be the farm area or trapper area. Yeah, so usually I just make a main line. And in the beginning I think I only need 2 of the emergency shelters, 6. I just like to build it like this so it's all very close to each other. It can be very bad in case of some disasters, but usually it will work out. So the village is actually... I mean, the developers did a good job of making your villagers a little self-sufficient. So if they don't have a job, they'll carry resources around. If they have a job, they'll just do their job. Pretty straightforward. Also, these guys need a message to tell me when they are idle. I think she's building. She should be building. Because if you don't build the houses fast enough, they'll be angry. Now, you could use wells and some other stuff to get water, but that's a little underdoing it, because it costs a lot of concrete. You don't want to waste too many resources in the beginning. And you want this to be 100% if possible. Actually, no. First, I like to build a fishing hut, because that will guarantee it's 100%. And the other one, the water collection, can be a little worse. Okay, that's 100%, perfect. Well, still 100%. Now, for the road, well, I guess... So we need to move the work area, so they actually gather some of the resources laying around. That was a small patch of berries. Okay, that's good over there. Now, I'm not sure what the roads really do, except for the colonists to move faster. I need something like this. Oh, and that's pollution. Well, that's bad. Oh, this will be a hard colony to build just because of all this nonsense. I like to build the roads anyway, just for show. Oh man, the pollution. See, this is what I don't like about the game. I need a special button to show me this exactly what it is. Okay, finally. Let's actually send one of the specialists to do it. And these guys are probably just wasting their time over here. Okay, go get the plants. It needs a lot of UI improvements and a lot of quality of life improvements, but generally it's quite good. Now, I really want to build the gate. Otherwise, I'll have a hard time getting all the resources I need, and you'll see why in a minute. Okay, production is good. And I also need a little bit of food production. Otherwise, I'll not have enough resources, but until I get the other population, the other villages will have a lot of trouble. Okay, in other words, if I don't get the other population that I need, we won't be able to do the small things. So, until then, I'll just rely on my specialist to give me the materials and some food along the way. Go and get the berries. Actually, get those ones. Yeah, let's prepare for a fire, actually. And I was right this time. If you guess the event, I guess nothing bad happens, and sometimes they are happier. Now, the biggest problem regarding resources for me in the beginning is, of course, plastic. Oh, we need to clear this area and make it a forest area as soon as possible. So yeah, let's work on the other resources. You don't really need metal in the beginning. It's good to have it so you can stockpile it as soon as possible. But the recycler is the main problem. Well, I guess I can build it over here. Yeah, it's not ideal, but I'll have to make do with what I have. And again, I don't want to start wood production because I don't have enough people. What's insufficient? Ah, yes, the metal. Well, then I really have to build a scrapper. I really want to clean this area up, but apparently it's not possible in the beginning. Yeah, sometimes just the map generation is too hard to handle. Ah, oh, whatever, I don't really need something over there. Well, they'll travel a lot to the next area, but I guess it can't really be helped. So we have the concrete and the planks needed for that. Now, what are these guys doing? They're probably wasting time. Yeah, go and get more planks. At least they can get the materials like, the more advanced materials like the metal. Or the plastic, because they need to be processed before they can be used. So yeah, can't do anything with that. Yeah, I mean it's very close and I have a road, so it shouldn't take long until we get to that. Also remember to move the work area, so this is similar to end zone, so similar. I'll rate the game duck out of 10, so leave me to... Let me play some more of it. Okay, everyone is working. Oh, she'll finish the berries right now. Gina, we really need the button like this on the UI over here. What is that chair living among the rubbish? Okay, we'll take the child in. I mean, I hope she's not a murderer or a psychopath, you know. Well, things are going nice and slowly. We have a few... Okay, so they take the materials and then they recycle them. We can't really research anything because we don't have the research points yet. We'll also make sure all the metal goes into the building of the gate. The sooner you send your little explorers or your little survivalist or specialist out there, the sooner you can get more of the plastic, which will really limit your building, so... Yeah. Also, as you can see, we don't have a lot of workers, so free carriers means we have only 3 people free to work for us. And I think we need a water storage as soon as possible, but that takes a lot of resources, sadly. Okay, let's see what these guys are doing. Yeah, go and get the berries, because they seem to have... They have problems getting the berries. I think it's gathering wood or something. Now at this point I don't really have anything else to do except for wait. I could build a medical tent, but that's a lot of resources, and if no one is sick, well, don't really need it. Well, let's just build. It's for safety, right? Let's just build one of these over here. It's kind of close to the pollution, but this is an area I'll not likely use anyway. So it's high, okay. And as soon as you build a gate, you can send them outside and they'll be able to... But I have a gate. No workers there. Okay, we'll send all of them to the world map. Because we don't really need them home. So, who is better at getting research points? You are. Okay, you'll go and get the research points. Which are added immediately to our stockpile. 200. Now, for this guy... How is your scavenge efficiency? I don't really need a mid. Go for the plastic and let me see what area looks like it's not so dangerous. I guess you have to scout over here because it's the closest to us. Oh, we didn't have enough skill points, so that works in a very weird way. They have skill points, or not skill points, they have action points they can use every day. So right now they used up all the points for the day. Now, when they come to Junior Colony, they usually have a lot of materials. One adult, one elder, and one child. Also, I have a scout, and this guy actually does everything in a good way, but as you can see, he has 100 health and recovers 25 HP. His damage is 20. Oh, he's actually perfect. Yeah, this is one of the things I don't like. So, you have a scout like this, which can do basically anything at a decent rate, and you have the other guys who... We can only do one thing, so the randomization is sometimes good, sometimes bad. Well, I guess I have to send them in another area. Marshland. Doesn't really matter what the biome is, you can still find good stuff everywhere. I like how the gate opens and closes. Sadly, this is one child and one elder. Their contamination is kind of bad. Oh, it was an adult and an elder? Anyway, things are going very well for us, but now we just have to wait until time passes. And we need another shelter, actually. I don't worry, later we'll actually expand almost the entire map, but for now we'll just sit around here. 5 carriers is a good amount of carriers. Also, let me see something else. Live beings, I want to see if we have any animals near us. Okay, no we don't. Actually, we don't have anything near us. Well, I guess we can build another fisherman's hut because the production of the food is kind of slow anyway. Trapper. I don't want to build that one because I don't have the replenishing... I don't have the forester just now. So that's an 83%. Well, 100%, great. Yeah, do that. So let's see what the other guys are doing on the overworld map. Well, he's doing nothing. I guess we can go and take the food. He will reach the plastics. Oh, that's food. That's canned food. Canned fruit. Nice. That was a good area to find. Bandit lair. Well, that will not be such a hard mission. Depends if it's warfare. Actually, let's do it so you can see the combat. And 0 action points for all of them. So yeah, that's it. They're actually getting the resources at a decent rate. Oh, I forgot to research. Yeah. I really want to do this because in the beginning I need a lot of food production, so let's research this one, which is production speed 20% for the fisherman's hut. And I'll have two of the fisherman's hat. Also, let's start building the other side of the production tab, which would be the lumber yard and the forester. As you can see, I have a lot of lumber, so that's why I kind of postponed that a bit. I could also use these ones, but these ones are a little more advanced, and for now I have the resources I need. Okay. In the beginning, it's actually much, much easier to play because you have a lot of the resources you need, and to be honest, nobody is sick, nobody is really injured. So what's the difference? Store and distribute? I don't know, maybe it just looks cooler. Anyway, let's just build that one over there. Deposit's depleted. We still have a small patch of berries and we still are gathering resources from that place. As you can see, the game is quite fun in the beginning, but I assure you, later on it will be a disaster. So, I think we should get our first catastrophe in about day 6 or 7. So for now, it's actually the easy part of the game. Yeah, you probably have made your decision about the game and if you like it or not, and I'll play more of it a little later, but for now, this is kind of like the basics of the colony. By the way, I didn't watch any tutorials, I didn't read any guides, so this is just me playing normally. Having 5 carriers seems to be kind of like the ideal spot in the beginning, so my opinion is that if I don't need something, I'll not build it. Anyway, let's save the game. And maybe we'll see more of the game, depending on how I do and how I like it. Bye.